ladies and gentlemen, and as always, thank you for watching. This morning is Saturday, March 23rd, 2019. We have a bit of a different job this morning. We're helping my daughter Lauren and her husband Talon move a portable shed from Chaffee to their house that they purchased, and Talon's had some rock work and stuff done, and we're gonna load the shed, hopefully load the shed onto this new number 15 rollback, haul it to their house and set it in place. Could be quite the chore, but we'll make it happen. I don't know if you can see. I know a lot of places up north are dealing with a lot of heavy flooding. The flooding has started down here. This is just the diversion channel, or I'm sorry, Ramsey Creek, which is one of the tributaries into the diversion channel that feeds into the Mississippi, and it's all backed up and out of the banks. But everything that's in the Missouri River now, up in Iowa and Nebraska, up in that way, will eventually move down through the Mississippi. We don't yet know what's going to happen here. I know I've had a lot of people ask. We just don't know. We are in a floodplain. All of this right here south of the diversion channel used to be Mississippi River Delta before the diversion channel was built. So this is all floodplain. Ask for prayers and good thoughts and well wishes for everybody that's dealing with the floodings up north, and for us down here, that we don't get any flooding, hopefully. I'm not going to go around him here in case he's going to go across that road crossing. Now it looks like he's going to turn in here. Spring is almost here. The farmers are starting to work the fields, as you can see right there. We've had a few dry days after a lot of rain. Today's supposed to be the last dry day before we get another week or more worth of rain and all the floods. So today, even though it's a Saturday, it's a weekend. Farmers and people like us, we really don't know what a weekend is. You do what you got to do when you got to do it. All right, I'm gonna shut up and get up here. We'll see you when we get to Chaffee. There's the shed. We're gonna take our rails off, the bedside rails, so that we can get the get the shed on here without riding the top of the rails. Bed rails have set bolts on them, set screws, set bolts, whatever you want to call it. So I'm loosening those, and we'll take the rails off. Not a big deal. These are on detents, which keep them shut. I don't think those will hurt. The drawers, maybe.
Them are just easy.
There's stuff in them.
Well, there isn't none of them.
I really don't think it'll hurt.
Okay. I would for sure. I think it'll.
I don't think it'll hurt them. I don't think so. All right, I guess I'm gonna try to wiggle myself in here.
Okay.
And then we'll take the, let's go ahead and take the bedsides.
Off.
Yeah, I've got them loose. Let's go ahead and
lay them in there.
Yeah, we'll just lay them in the floor.
We got a cool turf bed
now. Just lay them out in the, which one you got? You got the,
I got the next
middle?
One.
Okay. Side free spool switch. There you go. It's nice.
Yeah. Yeah, we was on that burn job the other morning. I kept trying to tell Raymond it's a lever up there.
Yeah, we've not had the one with the air free spool on the rollback. Well, let's check and see how they, is the back end tapered like that?
I think so.
If it's tapered like that, I don't know if those J-hooks will grab a hold. I was hoping they would, but.
Yeah.
Shoot. Shoot, shoot, shoot. That not good. Darn it, darn it, darn it. I was hoping that back end was flat.
What was it? A bolt through a board?
Yeah, that header board. I think that's a four before that's running in between there? How thick is that board?
What, that down the center?
It's running in between that runner.
It's two by on
the
bottom, yeah. Well, might be a 4x4 right up above that 2x. Yeah? There's a 4x4 sitting on this 2x.
Well, how about we sneak the bed underneath it and lift the front of it a little bit and see what we got. Let's take a look at it. How do we look there?
We're a little that way.
A little which way? Well, let's get the bed back and we'll see. Off much. Mm-hmm. 100-foot tape out the other night to Marty and I didn't get it back. You have a tape with you? You have a tape?
Yeah. I thought Marty brought it back to you. I bet he put it in the rotator.
Yeah, he probably put it in the rotator. We're off about an inch one side.
Oh.
We ain't, no deal there. No problem there. Thanks, sir.
You bet.
What do we look like under there? Twelve and a half here. In over here, so we're about 2 inches, a little over 2 inches off to one side, but I don't see that being an issue.
You don't know what sucks?
What?
You kneel down right here, you'll see it. You can wrap around that. But okay. That's not back there.
It's not?
No, it's not.
Okay.
It's like that back there.
Well,
it'd be good when we're going home.
Well, we can tie endless loops right here and just pull off the front.
Yeah.
We don't need it all the way from the back.
I was wondering if we would, though, because it's so long.
Yeah. Because we're not going to skid it all the way on the deck, remember? We got to have some laying off the tailboard,
yeah.
So that when we set it down,
yeah,
we don't want it all on the tailboard anyway.
Yep,
yeah, let's get that. We'll just take those green endless loops.
Go around through there.
We'll just choker it right through there. Actually just basket it, I think. That'll be better. If the veer angle doesn't get us. We're gonna have to choker it, I think. Maybe. Maybe not. Let's see. Get yours over here and let's see. May have to put a clevis in it.
You got one?
No, that ain't gonna be enough. Darn it.
Choker it?
Yeah, we're not gonna have a choice. Otherwise, we're gonna get too much veer angle and it's gonna pull these front together. Don't need to push your pole then.
Well, I'm glad that was there.
Put our chains up. There you go, sir. I don't want to take your tape.
Thank you.
Yep, thank you. Hey, Talon, lock my winch back in. Well, it's on the bed. Bring it up just a little bit farther. I took the snatch blocks off. That's as far as we can go forward on it without rehooking.
You got your pole?
Yeah, it's behind the seat. I'll have to grab it. What you need, bud?
I'm gonna
shut
that door.
Oh, the door? Yep, give me just a second. One pole. Okay, we've got multiple securements all the way around it. We have to leave the bed or the back of it hanging off a little bit so that when we tilt it down to deliver it, the back hits first. We got to try to wiggle out from our arch nemesis here, the power lines. Of course, the low lines are usually phone and cable and stuff like that, but we still don't want to knock any of them out. So it's going to be a trick wiggling out of here. Talon, I think I'm going to back up into his yard and pull forward to where your truck is, and then I'll have to have you help guide me backwards. And we'll go straight across that street into that alleyway. All right, let's do this. Come around this other side, and can you pull that mirror out for me, please? All I can see is building. I can't see anything but. Keep it going. All I see is building. All right, let off. Okay. Good. We need extendable mirrors here.
You're about 30 feet going forward to hit a water.
I'm not going any more forward. All right, we good to go back?
back out to 5th and turn around at that intersection. Oh, we could go up to the church parking lot.
Yes, sir. Nosy neighbors.
Yeah, go right ahead.
Called the police on you.
Why?
Because they thought you were setting this building. And I just...
Okay.
So he just called me and said, where are they going with that building? And I said, they're moving it. Well, they're not going. I said, no, Steve, they're...
Who's Steve?
Steve Lyon, the mayor. Oh. Lives right down here. Well, I've already called the police. I said, well, go call them and tell them that they're leaving with the building, not placing the building. You know, they've been...
What's the big deal?
Well, they have to have a permit.
Yeah.
To place one.
Well, maybe someone should check whether they have a permit.
Well, that's...
Instead of calling the police, maybe they should politely ask if there's a permit.
That's what I say, no neighbors.
That's why I don't live in Tempe.
Come down and talk to somebody before you go
stupid.
Sure.
Yeah, no kidding.
Sure.
Yeah, let's go to the church parking lot. That's best.
Yeah.
It's close, and we can do minimal tie downs that way.
All right. Well, we're wanted. Let's get out of town.
You're right. Thanks, sir. There went the police car right behind us.
Yeah, okay. All right, he's scoping you out.
We're leaving Chaffee. Don't worry. We're leaving. They don't want us here. We're gone.
Thank you, sir.
I want you here.
All right. We got the dogs called on it.
Oh, man.
That's awesome. Yeah. That's awesome. I'm always in trouble.
I'm following you.
Okay.
Close to Lauren and Talon's house. Now we have to turn it around. We have to completely unsecure this thing and turn it around for it to be in the right position for us to drop it at Lauren and Talon's. I did not get the front ones loose yet. We had her tied down good.
Well,
didn't move on us anywhere, so I guess that's good. Hey, Talon,
Yeah. Let's
put some blocks under it. You got some, right? I've got some here. I'm never without blocks, man.
Yeah, these are spreading way better.
Yep. Just giving me enough room to get the bed of the rollback under that lip. It's all I gotta have.
Again?
Yep, because it'll push the blocks back as
That's
we go.
Saying.
Yep. Good? All right, I'm just gonna reel nice and easy. Now I can't go all the way off the bed yet. We'll get a block and put it under there. Yeah, front box. There you go.
Damn, didn't have a small one?
Nope. Go big or go home. Good? Thank you.
got to have a chain. We took the endless loop slings and chokered them around there, but we can take chain, whatever, through the there's a hole right up here so that we winch it on. Yeah, we can use these same tie down chains, be fine. Howdy, howdy. One on each side. Instead of the chain, we'll just, or the
strap.
Yeah, instead of the strap. We can just make long loops in them and grab the hook here. That way we're not squeezing on it like we did with the others. You know what I mean, Tal? Here, now we'll take this.
Oh, I got it.
And make a big loop here, so that, and then we'll hook both of them together here. To the side so I can get the bed under them. Okay. Good enough. We lost our hook. You were no longer hooked it. One leg is longer than the other, so we're gonna have to either lengthen yours or shorten Dad's. One of the two. Otherwise, it'll come up at an angle. Still got enough to hold it there.
Yeah,
right, everybody clear?
Yeah.
It's pulling that runner towards me. Hey, Dad. Worked on the other end real well.
Yeah, it ain't working on this one.
Okay, well, other option is to go all the way to the other end. Yep.
You got enough time to do that one?
Yep. I'll get the pole out. Push the pole. Everybody stand clear and I'll raise the bed. Got the underreach down so that it's solid. Okay, let me get the push pole. Yep, just take your chain. There you go. Okay. Nope.
I need something though that will go across the park.
Right.
And hit the okay.
Those blocks are underneath it. Can you lift it? Those are my long blocks. Watch me. Yeah. That ain't square though. It ain't near like what we had. Come up around the front. Let me level the bed out. I need you to push this side, the front over. We're off center with it.
Back here?
No, the front is way off center. We've gotten stuck several times. There's a really bad wash out there. Talon's got mats, construction mats that we borrowed from a friend of ours. We've had to use the John Deere to pull the little Pete out once or twice, and now we're putting more mats. We're in a really, really bad washout right there. If we ever get past that, we should be okay. But we're gonna put the mats down, put some more mats down, and tie the skid steer to the back and see if we can't ease it back and go from there.
Yeah,
You can holler at him. I'm gonna get over here.
Thank you. foot.
Back to.
I'll lift this one up. Y'all can drag that one this way. Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, it took a lot more time and a lot more equipment than we thought, but we finally got it set. It's level and we're getting out with the truck slowly but surely on the construction mats. We got her done safely. That's all that matters. Anyway, there's Lauren and Talon's new shed. As always, thank you for watching. God bless.